A, Amy, A minus B. Close, times, open again,
Yes, that's correct. So this is the second identity, and today we will study this second one as well. So, but I want to show you the proof. Why A squared minus B squared is equal to A minus B times A plus B. Look at this geometric representation explanation now. We have a square again, but now I will change it. So one of the side of this square will be A. So this side is A. And if this is A, and let's say this length is B, this is B, this is B. If the whole side is B, this one will be A minus B, because A minus B, that's the remaining part, and this part will be A minus B. Why? The whole length is A. If you subtract B from A, it will be A minus B. And this part will be A minus B, okay? A minus B, sorry. I need A square minus B square. What can you say about the whole area? The area of the whole square will be A square. Why? One of the side is A. This is A, because A minus B plus B is A. And this side is A. This is together A, because A minus B plus B is A. So the total area is A square. But I need to find A square minus B square. Look at this. I am subtracting B square. What is this? What is the area of this one?
B square.
B square.
B square.
So I am taking this one. B square is here. This is B square. So I am writing B square. The area of the small square is B square. Now the remaining area is A square minus B square, is it? Because total area was A square. I took B square part. So the remaining area is A square minus B square. Now let's take a look at that area. I am taking this one. I will put it here. Okay, somewhere there. Nice. And I will take this one. But how can I connect them? Look at the trick now. I will take this and I will place the rectangle here. Okay, so it fits perfectly. Then this is totally A square minus B square, total area. But how can I calculate the area using the, I mean, how can I add these two figures? I have two rectangles. One of them is red, second one is blue. Let us find the area of a blue rectangle. So this side was A minus B. Just I am writing the side length, A minus B. This is A minus B, because it was A minus B. We took that here. Look at this. It was A minus B here. A minus B, one of the sides. So what can you say about the longest side? It was A here. So I'm writing A. This is A. What about this length? It was B. Remember, it was B. And this is B. This is A. So what can you say about the area of this whole rectangle? Who will tell me the area of this rectangle now? The area of a rectangle is product of both sides. So let's take a look at the sides. First side is, as you can see, this is the first side. It is A minus B. So I'm writing the first side. So the first side is A minus B. Can you tell me the length of the longest side? What is the length of the longest side? Look at this. It starts from here, A plus B. So the longest side is A plus B. So I'm writing that here. So at the end, we will get A plus B. Look at this. A square minus B square is equal to A minus B times A plus B. So we prove this using geometry. Let me show you this again. Look at this. It was here. Second one was there. And third one was here. So together, this is A square. It was A square. I took B square. I put B square here. Remaining part is A square minus B square. So this area gives us A square minus B square. So let us calculate the area. So I have the first rectangle. I am taking the second rectangle, but here we have a trick. Just I will rotate that rectangle, and I will place that rectangle the top of the blue rectangle. When you calculate the area, A minus B is the shortest side, A plus B is the longest side. When you multiply A minus B by A plus B, you will get the area. So A square minus B square is equal to A minus B times A plus B.